talk about a hymn made a good hymn. No hymn, but a shout all over him. I got shoes, you got shoes.
All the gods chilling got shoes. Gonna put on, walk all over God's heaven. Heaven. I don't know where that is in the Bible that talks about all of us having shoes. But, if it's real stony and stuff, I hope that's gonna come in handy. 2 Corinthians 5:17 is what I was focusing on today. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. All things. That's pretty heady. That's pretty, can be slightly overwhelming stuff, really, when you think about it. It's glorious in that I might be transformed from flesh, from natural self, rife with all sorts of nasty little bits and selfish desires galore. Even a lot of my kinder instincts come from a need to be desired, a need to be loved, a need to be appreciated, doing things for good things for a sense of approbation. And Christ calls you to, like, really step away. He can shift you into that, into stepping away and becoming the pursuit of him. It ultimately becomes the fleeing from selfishness, from self-involvement, from self-centeredness, to where your mind is first for God's, and second for others, and thirdly for yourself. You don't completely fall apart, you know? I don't know if you don't see a lot of Christians wandering around vagabond style. Some are called to do so. And enough respect, yo. But the simplest sense, I don't know, I was thinking of it this morning, and I don't know if this is going to be helpful to anybody, but hopefully it will be. I came up with this while I was praying. And what I was asking for God to do in keeping me and making me this new thing, which he's been doing for a very long time. I think probably almost anybody who's watched this, or anybody who's watching this and knows me, has actually known me since he's been transforming me. So anything you like in me, props. So anyway, I came up with this thing this morning that I guess I'll call the 3 G's. And this is what I prayed to God to continue to do to me, and ways in which he has shaped me and kept me a new thing. The 3 G's. Guard me, gird me, and gild me. 3 G's. It's catchy, right? And briefly explained, guard me, in that I have a intercessor in the spiritual realm where, and I know you've all felt this and maybe call it different things, but you felt your life not only just be hard and just have struggles, but like times when you just feel like assaulted by the something. I don't know what, but something is messing with you, and it's not just Murphy's Law, and I don't know what it is, but it's something out there. Not always, necessarily, but sometimes that is completely legitimate. There is such a thing as a spiritual realm, and there is good there, and there is evil there. And so that's first and foremost, Lord, make me a new man. Guard me from those, especially any attacks I'm receiving. Just guard me from the stuff I can't handle, things that are so out of my pay grade, it's ridiculous. gird me, which is clothe me in the robes of righteousness, which is gird my loins with truth, which is put on the gird me in the breastplate of righteousness. Fortify me. God is fortifying me to guard against that which I can guard against. Through the power, and this is all through just the power of his changing love, his transforming love. Love, man, love. Faith, hope, and love, but the greatest of these is love. Secondly, gird me. Prepare me. Make me useful to you. Make me useful to myself. And make me useful to others. That I might prevail against, spiritual or physical attacks on others. That I might shine his light. That I might be just shield covered in all the armaments to do battle in this earth, and then thirdly, gild me. And no, not like the thief's guild of the new moon of Artoris or whatever, World of Warcraft style. I know that's not a real guild. WoW players, please don't mock me. But gild me in the golden form of Christ, which is really the way I do all of this, which is continue to shape me, transform me, yank stuff out of my hands I don't need to be playing with, and the thoughts that preoccupy me, and the spiritual attacks I may face, and the situations I may get myself in, gild me in the image, in the golden image of Jesus Christ, who came here to offer us a way to escape damnation, to escape ourselves, to escape that which in ourselves is debased, and to give us a sweet, sweet taste of what is to come, and of how we can be of service, not only to our community, to our community being the literal people around us, but to the creator of the universe. 3 G's. Guard, gild, gird. I don't know why this is of particular interest, but maybe it'll be come out. I'm looking for great stories. So my question of the day, when I was talking about spiritual assault thing, has that ever happened to you? Have you ever had those days, weeks, months, years where you're just like, something's going on here? I don't know if that makes you turn to like an astrological thing, what it made you turn to, and you're like, who's in retrograde? Why is everything malfunctioning in my life? Why am I being assaulted? Has that ever happened? And what was your solution? And what was your sense of it? And how did you know that it was more than just like a bummer of a day? All right, so that's it. That's what I'm thinking about today. That's what I'm going to work on. I'm going to work on my 3 G's. What up? And love to all.